Senate will come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise and recite the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag, the United States of America, and to the Republic, which is said, one nation under God, with liberty and justice for all.
In the absence of clergy, I ask everyone to please, for a moment of silent reflection or prayer. Yeah. Reading of the journal.
In Senate, Friday, April 14th, 2023, the Senate member pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Thursday, April 13th, 2023, was read and approved on motion to Senate adjourn.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentations of petitions, messages from the Assembly. Senate Secretary will read.
Senator Henchy moves to discharge from the Committee on Cultural Affairs, Tourism, Parks and Recreation, Assembly Bill Number 4822, substituted for the identical Senate Bill 5345, third reading count of 586.
So ordered. Messages from the Governor. Reports of standing committees, reports of select committees, communications and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Senator Gennaris.
Good afternoon, Madam President. On behalf of Senator Savisky, I wish to call up Senate Print 3473, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 515, Senate Print 3473 by Senator Savisky, an act to amend the education law.
By which the bill was passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gennaris, Kruger, Orr, Stewart, Cousins, White, ayes 55.
The bill is restored to its place on the third reading calendar.
For the following amendments.
Amendments are received. The bill will return its place on the third reading calendar.
Can we now take up a previously adopted Resolution 545 by Senator Sepulveda, read its title, and recognize Senator Sepulveda on the resolution.
Secretary will read.
Senate Resolution 545 by Senator Sepulveda, celebrating the historic visit of the Honorable Dr. Milton Ray Guevara, President of the Constitutional Court of the Dominican Republic, to the New York State Senate and Court of Appeals.
Senator Sepulveda on the resolution.
Thank you, Madam President, for allowing me to present this resolution today. It is with great honor that I bring an incredible esteemed group of individuals from the Dominican Republic. They are the members of the Constitutional Court of the Dominican Republic, which is equivalent to our United States Supreme Court. And they've been here with us since this morning. We had a visit to the Court of Appeals where we met with the acting Chief Judge Canataro and Judge Singus and Judge Jenny Rivera, who joined us today. It's my pleasure to welcome all of them here today to the New York State Senate for this historic moment. It is the first time that a delegation from the highest court of the Dominican Republic that has ever visited our chamber and has visited the Court of Appeals. The Dominican Constitutional Court is a symbol of justice, equality, and the rule of law of the Dominican Republic. As an institution, it has played a pivotal role in safeguarding the constitutional rights of the Dominican people and ensuring that justice is served in an equitable and transparent manner. The visit of the court to our state senate is a testament to the strong and enduring relationship between the Dominican Republic and the United States. It is an opportunity for us to strengthen our ties, deepen our mutual understanding, and learn from each other and our experiences in the field of law and governance. As a representative of the people of New York, we are committed to upholding the values of justice, democracy, and human rights. Now, we recognize the vital role that the Dominican Constitutional Court plays in promoting these values in the Dominican Republic. And we stand in solidarity with the court in its efforts to defend the constitutional rights of all Dominicans. In closing, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to the members of the Dominican Constitutional Court for gracing us with their presence today. We look forward to engaging in fruitful discussions and learning from our expertise and experience. Let us work together to build a more just and equitable, prosperous future for our people. And I'd like to indulge in naming these great court judges that are here and visiting us today. But before that, I have to acknowledge that we're also blessed with the presence of the Dominican ambassador, Sonia Guzman. We're also with us today is the Consul General of New York, Eligio Jaques, and a member of the Dominican Senate, who has been instrumental in creating these exchanges that we've been doing with the Dominican Republic, with the New York State Senate, and with New York State government, my dear friend, Senator Alexis Victoria Jeb. Now, we were blessed by the following judges, the Chief Judge, Milton Ray Guevara, Judge Rafael Diaz Filpo, Judge Victor Joaquin Castellano Pisano, Judge Jose Alejandro Ayuso, Judge Alba Luis Bead Marcos, Judge Manuel Ulises Bonelli Vega, Judge Pedro Castellano Cori, Judge Domingo Hill, Judge Maria del Carmen Santana, Judge Miguel Valera Montero, Judge Jose Alejandro Vargas Guerrero, and Judge Eunices Vasquez, and we also, the Secretary of the Tribunal, Attorney Grace Ventura Rondon. This to me is a high honor. I was recently granted Dominican citizenship by the President of the Dominican Republic about 7 or 8 months ago, and it is because of Judge Milton Rey Guevara, who rewrote the Dominican Constitution and added a provision in there for dual citizenship so that Dominicans in the diaspora, any of you, would like to become a Dominican citizen, you have that opportunity and retain your American citizenship. So I am really honored today. We had a wonderful session at the Court of Appeals where we had an exchange of ideas and had a discussion about dual citizenship here in Hearing Room A. And let me indulge just quickly in Spanish. Es un honor estar aquí con estos jueces de la Corte Constitucional de la República Dominicana. Estamos honrados hoy, tenerlos hoy, los llevamos a la Corte de Apelación del Estado de Nueva York, que es la corte más alta aquí en el Estado de Nueva York. Tuvimos un discurso con los miembros, los jueces, los magistrados de la República Dominicana, con la embajadora Sonia Guzmán, con el Consul General Eligio Jaques, y mi amigo el senador Victoria Jeb. Es un honor tenerlos todos aquí, ustedes aquí. Es un honor participar en los intercambios que estamos haciendo y continuar de trabajar no solamente para los dominicanos aquí, pero los dominicanos en la diáspora. Muchas gracias. Thank you, Madam President, for allowing me to address the Senate and introduce these fantastic individuals who represent justice and fairness in the Dominican Republic. Thank you.
Thank you. The resolution was adopted on 4-10. To our guests, I welcome you to the Senate. We extend to you the privileges and courtesies of this House. Please rise and be recognized. Senator Gennaris.
Madam President, I believe Senator Sepulveda would like to open that resolution for co-sponsorship.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. Should you choose not to be a co-sponsor of the resolution, please notify the desk. Senator Gennaris.
There will now be an immediate meeting of the Rules Committee in room 332.
There will be an immediate meeting of the Rules Committee in room 332.
The Senate will stand at ease.
The Senate will stand at ease. The Senate will return to order. Senator Gennaris.
Madam President, there's a report of the Rules Committee at the desk. Can we please take that up?
The Secretary will read.
Senator Stuart Cousins from the Committee on Rules reports the following bills. Senate Print 1213B by Senator Clear, an act to amend the education law. Senate Print 5622 by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the tax law. Senate Print 6340 by Senator Krueger, an act making appropriations for the support of government. Bills report directed third reading.
Move to accept the report of the Rules Committee.
All those in favor of accepting the Rules Committee report signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The Rules Committee report is accepted. Senator Gennaris.
Please take up the reading of the calendar.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 194, Senate Print 965 by Senator Bailey. An act authorizing and directing the Commissioner of Education to conduct a study on the number of children who are caregivers.
Read the last section.
Section 3. This action took effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannakis, Kruger, Orr, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 56.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 279, Senate Print 2854 by Senator Skoufis. An act to amend the Alcoholic Beverage Control Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2. This action took effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannakis, Kruger, Orr, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 56.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 304, Senate Print 2095 by Senator Thomas. An act in relation to authorizing the County of Nassau Assessor to accept an application for a retroactive real property tax exemption.
Read the last section.
Section 2. This action took effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannakis, Kruger, Orr, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Martins to explain his vote.
And I just rise to recuse myself from this vote. Thank you.
Senator Martins is recused from this vote. Announce the results.
In relation to ayes 57, Senator Martins abstaining from voting.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 555, Senate Print 4596 by Senator Kennedy, an act to amend the local finance law.
There's a home rule message at the desk. Read the last section.
Section 2, this action takes effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannakis, Kruger, Orr, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 58.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 563, Senate Print 2266 by Senator Kruger, an act to amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this action takes effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannakis, Kruger, Orr, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 58.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 569, Senate Print 3118 by Senator Mannion, an act to amend the mental hygiene law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this action takes effect on the 120th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannakis, Kruger, Orr, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 58.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 573, Senate Print 400 by Senator Stewart Cousins, an act to amend the local finance law.
There's a home rule message at the desk. Read the last section.
Section 2, this action takes effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannakis, Kruger, Orr, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 58.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 575, Senate Print 2573 by Senator Gonardes, an act to amend the civil practice law and rules.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this action takes effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannakis, Kruger, Orr, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 575, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Borrello, Kesner, Fitzpatrick, Lanza, Rose, and Tedesco. Ayes 53, nays 5.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 583, Senate Print 1458 by Senator Serrano, an act creating a legislative task force on outdoor environmental education.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this action takes effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannakis, Kruger, Orr, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 58.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 586, Assembly number 4822 by Assemblymember Werner, an act to amend the Parks, Recreation, and Historic Preservation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this action takes effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannakis, Kruger, Orr, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 58.
The bill is passed. Senator Gennaris, that completes the reading of the calendar.
Let's take up the reading of the supplemental calendar.
Secretary will read. There's a substitution at the desk. Secretary will read.
Senator Kruger moves to discharge from the Committee on Rules. Assembly Bill number 6550, substituted for the identical Senate Bill 6340, third reading count of 592.
Necessity and appropriation at the desk.
There is a message of necessity and appropriation at the desk.
Message of necessity and appropriation.
All those in favor of accepting the message, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The message is accepted and the bill is before the House.
Laid aside.
Senator Gennaris, that completes the reading of the supplemental calendar.
Can we now go to the controversial calendar?
Secretary will ring the bell. Secretary will read.
Calendar number 592, Assembly number 6550 by Assemblymember Weinstein. An act making appropriation for the support of government.
Senator Borrello, why do you rise?
Madam President, would the sponsor yield for a question?
Senator Krueger, do you yield?
I'm here to do that. Yes, Madam President.
Sponsor yields.
Through you, Madam President, has the sponsor ever seen Groundhog's Day, the movie Groundhog's Day?
I have. I actually really like that movie.
Well, the sponsor yield for another question.
Like that movie.
Does the sponsor yield? Does the sponsor
yes,
yield?
Of course I yield.
Okay, good.
The sponsor yields.
So we have a 3-day extender here in front of us for the, just curious, what do we expect to see in the budget negotiations? I mean, I think 3 days is rather, we'll call it ambitious at the moment.
So actually, this isn't Groundhog Day because you're right. It's a different extender, a different timeline, a different amount of money. So it's not Groundhog Day. I'm hoping we will be continuing budget negotiations and getting closer and closer to a moment in time where we can actually stand on this floor and say, look at the budget bills we're here to debate. But we're not there today. I don't know that we will be there by Thursday, but I suspect we would all like to be there.
Madam President, will the sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor yield?
Yes.
The sponsor yields.
Thank you for that. So, do we have table targets? Have they been decided yet? Can you tell us?
Any specific sections that have been decided?
Your dealer's choice.
Oh. No, Madam President. We have no budget bills before us. Hence, we have no actual official agreements to discuss on this floor. At the time that bills are in print, we will know that agreements have been made in such a way that we can all review, debate, and vote on.
Thank you, Madam President. Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor yield?
Yes.
The sponsor yields.
Through you, Madam President. So if we were to vote on a budget this week, would that require a message of necessity from the governor?
Yes, that would be correct. Well, let's see. If a bill went to print by tonight, we could technically have 3 days without needing a message of necessity. But I suspect if we are doing budget bills for the remainder of this week, they will probably need messages of necessity, as this extender before us just required a message of necessity.
Thank you, Madam President. Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor yield?
Yes.
The sponsor yields.
So we obviously had a Judiciary Committee meeting today, and Judge Wilson was discussed. The timing, considering we are in this budget overtime, seems a little suspect. Has there been any connection made with the governor between the nomination of Judge Wilson and the budget? A budget negotiation, I should say.
So I am not in three ways with the governor and the two leaders, but I am not aware of any discussion tying in the chief judge nomination with the budget discussion. I'm also not on the Judiciary Committee, although I hear they had a very robust hearing earlier today and did vote in favor of bringing Judge Wilson to the floor as the next chief judge. But I don't think there was really a timing correlation with the budget negotiations, since we know we are looking to fill the chief judge position. We had to turn down the last nomination, so I don't sincerely think there's much of a surprise that there would be a nomination moving at this time, since I guess it was right, was it 2 weeks ago, where the commission made their recommendations of their new list to the governor, and I think there's an expectation by all of us that she would move to pick a nominee from that list relatively quickly. That does seem to be what happened, and the committee has acted today in a timely way. So I don't really think there's intentional correlation between the timing of the judge and the budget. They're both hitting around the same time this year.
Madam President, will sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor yield?
Yes.
The sponsor yields.
All right, so we'll just take this as an amazing coincidence, I understand. So last Monday, we were here, and we were told by the comptroller that if we didn't pass a bill by noon, our employees wouldn't get paid, the extender, all those things that this extender entails. Yet here we are at 4:30 the following Monday, and we still don't have an extender, and yet there's been no warning from the comptroller that the employees won't get paid. So we've had three extenders that have essentially had three different deadlines. Can you explain why?
It's an excellent question. I don't know that I can, other than it is true. Last week we were told by the controller there was a deadline of noon. I don't believe we heard anything like that from the controller this week. So I guess the timing for the filing of papers and sending out checks didn't hit today at noon. It's the best I can offer right now, unless I have some staff who want to update me on that. So I'm told that last week the papers had to go out on Wednesday, hence there was a Monday noon deadline for the processing. This week they don't have to go out till Thursday. So I guess if we were having this discussion tomorrow, it would have to be by noon, but we're getting it done on Monday, hopefully. Thank you.
Madam President, sponsor continue to yield.
Does the sponsor yield?
Yes.
The sponsor yields.
Thank you for that. So we'll just say it a little different day. You know, is there any, does this bill have any policy in it, this particular bill? Is there any policy in this extender?
No, our understanding, it's the same money that was added last week for the DOH funding for the community-based organizations who had been losing 340B. But it's just a continuation of that, and we had the discussion last week with your colleague next to you. And otherwise, there's no other changes. It's just different weeks have different costs for the state, so they're different numbers.
Madam President, sponsor, continue to yield.
Does the sponsor yield?
I do.
Sponsor yields.
So within this bill, you know, obviously we got this bill really quickly, and not a whole lot of time to analyze it. But yet there are amendments made to the language in the appropriations for the Office of Temporary and Disability Assistance. Can you explain why those changes were made?
I'm back. Sorry, Madam President. So my understanding is that last week the draft from the governor that we did pass had some technical language incorrectness for OTDA. So this week the governor's offices corrected the language. So this appropriation language is technically correct when last week's apparently had a problem.
Madam President, sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor yield?
I do.
The sponsor yields.
So last week's had a problem, but this would be considered then a chapter amendment to last week's bill?
I don't call it a chapter amendment, Madam President, because it's technically, that extender came and went. So that time period and that money was spent. So this is a new bill for a new period of time with more correct language in it. Chapter amendments are usually defined as we pass the bill and we've already discussed with the governor why, in order not to veto a bill, they would like us to make some changes in it. Not that I'm sure that that's a legal technical definition, but that's my standard how life works here definition of chapter amendments.
Madam President, on the bill.
Senator Borrello on the bill.
First of all, thank you, Senator Krueger, for the time today. You know, people talk about transparency in government and a government serves the people. Well, we have an extender here that was dropped for a three-day extension as opposed to a week or whatever it might be, and yet we only had a matter of hours before we had a message of necessity for the governor. That's not really transparent. That's just rushing things through so that people, particularly people outside this chamber, outside this Capitol, actually have the time to go through it and determine what it is. We had plenty of time to do it. We could have given this the full 3 days. We could have let this bill age. We're here. It appears we're going to be here most of the week. So why not give it that opportunity? We rush things through. We push things through. As far as the nominee for the highest court, the chief of the highest court, I don't believe that it was just a due diligence thing. I think the governor is trying to negotiate, and essentially she's going to perhaps win the battle of getting a little bit of tweaking to bail, but lose the war when it comes to having a chief judge that is a good jurist and not an activist. And I think that's what we're facing in the near future. That's a problem for New Yorkers. So this might be, you know, a few yards gain for the governor, but we're going to lose the big game for the people of New York State. So thank you, Madam President.
Thank you. Are there any other senators wishing to be heard? Seeing and hearing none, the debate is closed. The secretary will ring the bell. Read the last section.
Section 2 is actually take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ortsur, Cousins, Weick.
Announce the results.
Ayes 59.
The bill is passed. Senator Giannaris, that completes the reading of the controversial calendar.
Thank you, Madam President. On behalf of Majority Leader Stuart Cousins and in consultation with Senator Ord, I hand up the following committee assignment of the Minority Conference and ask that it be filed in the journal.
Judice. Hand up is received and will be filed with the clerk.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
I move to adjourn until tomorrow, Tuesday, April 18th at 3 p.m.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, April 18th at 3 p.m.